Hello, dude and dudettes, and welcome to Assassin's Creed on mobile. So, Ubisoft has released a couple, I believe it was a couple other Assassin's Creed games on a mobile, or maybe just one. And quite frankly, they weren't that impressive. I'll be honest. For me, anyways, I didn't really like them. Now, this one came out very recently, and a lot of people may not like the style that this game is in, which is super deformed characters or chibi, whatever you want to call it. And I personally have absolutely no problem with this, coming from playing Gundam like Super Robot Wars, all the other stuff, MapleStory. I'm very used to SD characters or super deformed, right? That's what SD stands for, super deformed. And I quite like it. So this game is, your very generic mobile action. Well, not very action, but it's very puzzly, and I really quite like it. I'm gonna get to the points sooner or later. So let me jump into the action to show you how this game works. So currently, there's this event to get Assassin's Creed 6, I believe, Odyssey characters, and my God, I think they released this a bit too early. Maybe. Then again, level 16 is the highest level, so I don't know. I wasn't really playing this game like super devoted. I was just playing this on and off, and I'm only up to like here. The best I can do, not even level 11. The best I can do is level 10 without losing too much. And quite frankly, the rankings shows. Okay, the rankings. I did not pay anything to get extra ticket, Rift tickets, or anything to play more of this. I only use the free tickets that you accumulate at the top over time, okay? And I've already ranked 13. Is that not ridiculous? Maybe it is. Maybe it's also because I got some quite lucky and got characters, right? That boosts the amount of event points I get upon winning. So that's nice. I'll show this later. So it gives you some ideas how this game seems like, what you can do. So first of all, I'm gonna go back to missions, right? Gonna do a mission here. Let's see. So there are your main story quests detonated by the yellow gold, and then you have your side quests. You can see the hammer, the bicep fist pumping, and DNA. They're pretty self-explanatory. The hammer gets you crafting materials. Upon completing any of them, right, you get crafting materials for you to craft your stuff, your weapons, your armor, and your accessories. And then the biceps, as you can already guess, is for training. When you complete it, you get these codexes, or codices, actually. I think you could pronounce this codices. And you use them for leveling up your characters. This game is not like the other games where when you do win a battle or anything, you get EXP. Instead, you have to personally train them, which I think is very annoying, because right now, even at my level, I can't, even with my training route upgraded, I only have one single slot, and it's not this already been upgraded once. The next upgrade level is at 13, and it only reduces time. Not even training, not even like another slot. That's so annoying. I have to train them one by one. Sure, the training time is somewhat short. It's not more than an hour, even if I train from level 1 to 10, but it's still, I don't have the time to just keep coming back, really. I just come playing it on and off. So maybe that's why I'm also very behind as well. Anyways, but yeah, then you got your workshop to craft your weapons. Like I said, you get your materials to craft, and then you got your armor right here, and then you got your accessories. They got different types, so you got a accessory you can give to whatever accessory they want. So you pick one that's best for your character, and then your armor also has differences as well, heavy and light, and they also got variations within them for different type of characters. You do you, right? Same with weapons. Anyway, back to the mission. Quit less bullshitting. Well, I don't even know what bullshitting is. Let's see. I'm gonna go to DNA, because as you guess, you get characters by collecting enough DNA to craft a set character. And I need to get some DNA points for this dude, because he's pretty nice. So characters are all separated into different classes, and they all do very specifically different things. So team recommendations, they already tell you here. Recommend to have a good at DPS, good at stealth, and a power recommendation. But you don't have to always follow that. So I'm gonna go with this team. Aguilar. Oh man, I love this guy. He's the very first assassin you will get. It's given to you after like at the very start, and he has a very impressive he doesn't seem very impressive like you might say seem like here, right? But he's actually pretty damn impressive. So as a basic free assassin that he gives the game gives you, he's already adept in assassination techniques, and then he's also adept in free running to do acrobatics and stuff. So that's pretty nice. And passive, his lethality also increased by 12%, so he got better assassination skills. But all right, let's go. We'll start this battle. So the reason why I want to get some Lois is because he's a pretty good stealth assassin. Each assassin or your character each have their own special abilities and perks. So for instance here, this is not a very good instance because I'm gonna show you. So you, oh right, I'm gonna show you that. So then you start combat because there's no other options. Why Aguilar is good? Aguilar, I don't know how you pronounce his name, sorry. You start throwing knife. Does extra damage and also boosts your chance of provide initiative, so we get your first turn even quicker. Such a good deal, man. And then just kshink, dead. So then you have a chest here. So, and chest is there's two ways to open it. Either you see here by brute force breaking it, which is very, it's an option, but it's usually never good. Because the reward that you get decreased so much, it's not even worth bothering with chests if you don't have a lock picker. Thankfully, Lewis here is a lock picker. Yay! You picked this Scott lock. Yeah! Hell yeah. And I got, see, full loot. If I just broke the lock, right, I might only get only one. Only one. If not even lesser rewards. For instance, the max, maybe you get 500 coins, right? By picking the lock, full of loot. If you break the lock, you only get like 5 to 20 coins. That's such a huge decrease from 500 as full loot to a measly 20. So you don't have a lock picking skill? Don't even bother with the chests. You don't even get anything from it. And it's the same with the event. Oops, sorry. The event, right? Every single time you open a chest, it's always gonna be event points, right? And maybe sometimes the equipment, the bonus equipment that they give, that the game, mission provides. But then if you break the lock, you don't get jack diddly squat. You only get like, what, 2, 5 to 20 extra event points. Whoa, so worth. Ah, shit, I forgot to showcase. God damn it, whatever. I'll show it later. Yeah, when you attract people's attention, you just throw coins on the ground like, ooh, coins! Ooh, I wonder who dropped coins here. Let me go check. You might be wondering, can you backstab him? Well, no. Unfortunately, Lewis is not an assassination assassin. He doesn't know any assassination techniques. He's merely like a thief. So he only does very basic stuff. Aguilar, however, is an assassination assassin, as then he has a skill here, assassination adept, and he can use four times in a map. Let's see. All right, so let's go on here, and then we can just. I could actually just not assassinate him and just kill him flat out because I have enough damage, but I'm just gonna assassinate him to show you what it does, how it looks like. Coins. Ah, you fall for a trap card. So free running up here, it's dependent on the character's agility. Now you see that you got two options, both at 95%. Which would you choose? Generally, it's because Aguilar is too high leveled for this map already, and he's already 3 stars, whereas usually you might be at 1 or 2 stars. So regardless, usually the adept skill boosts your stats and provides you a better chance of succeeding these actions But we can go with Jabber here. It's fine. I don't think that's really how physics is supposed to work in real life, but whatever, right? I just love these little animations. They're so well animated and so cute. It's amazing, like, they put so much effort into this game. For what it is, these little animations are wonderful. So now we got to our first objective, which is supposed to be, mess with information. Now, see here, as an assassination, he has the option to assassinate, but whereas the stealth, nothing, or my melee DPS, nothing. So, I'm just gonna assassinate him, or not. Actually, I'm just gonna kill him in one hit. Oh, crap. Well, I dodged it, thankfully. I forgot to hit my throwing knife first, and then he's dead. Now we mess with one objective, and voila. Alright, now you may be wondering, what now? Well, the thing is, you can always go backwards. Any rooms that you unlock, right, you can just go straight backwards just like this. And you can find ways. There's two, you can find different paths. For instance, when I was down here, I could choose to either go down this route or go up. Down, you see there's a lot of enemies, which would be useful for her. This character, Beatrice, she does a lot of AoE damage. And you see, she has one skill here, Swipe, that does AoE. And then she has Maiming Sweep that also does AoE. Fantastic skills. But I didn't choose to do so because I wanted to use it here, on this spot. At any given point, you can only engage two enemies at most, which I guess is fine. Yeah, take that bleed. Watch, that guy, and he's bled to death. How nice. Parry and die. Ooh. You might be wondering how come that dude attacked faster. Well, logically, different weapons have different attack speeds. So me using a two-handed weapon on Beatrice, well, she can only use two-handed weapons. She would definitely have lesser attack speed. Whereas, say, Lewis, he uses a dagger. He will have much superior attack speed than any other characters. But because of that, reduce attack damage. Compared to other weapons, you know, all this RPG stuff makes a lot of sense, right? So as you can see here, I have options. As a stealth assassin, I can stealth right through, or as an assassination assassin, I can assassinate them and go through. I'm just gonna go stealth right through. Whoop. Bling. The coins are what attracts their attention, every one of them. Anyways, I'm just gonna speed this up now because we've already seen most of what the combat has to offer. This is about as much combat you'll get from this game. And you get to choose sides, you know. You get to choose how you want to, your paths to be. You can assume how the paths to be and such and such. So I'm going to go up here and then just jump up. Proficiency the next area. Jump on down. And jump on down. Hello. And goodbye. And goodbye to you too. And then throw a knife and stabby stabby. And done. And that was it. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. And I still don't get any DNA for Lois. God damn, I already did my 3 for today and it was not, none of them were Lois's. Jeez, that's terrible. I'm almost about to level up too. That'd be nice when I do. So now that's about it. You just keep rinse and repeating and grind and grind and grind. This is a very supposedly casual game. You can play hardcore style if you want, just pay money and that's good. What's gonna, then that's that, right? I like how they also have this kind of challenge here, Animus Challenge, right? It refreshes every few days, and when you complete it, right, you get Helix Crystals, which is the premium currency, which is very nice. I like how they provide this kind of option. Aside from your daily quests, which also provides you with 20 as well, very nice. It's easier to complete these daily quests as well. It's simple, not much chores to do. I like it. simple. It's designed for mobile and also has a way for you to play when you want to pay premium. For instance, like I'm over here in this ranking. I'm telling you, I literally have done no payment to anything, okay, to get more Rift. And then we take a look at rank one. Literally doubled my points. Literally. Second place, not so much, but that's ridiculous. It's crazy. Pretty sure they do spend a little bit, maybe not. Because like I said, getting characters to boost your resource rate, event points, is very nice, okay? Very nice. I want to see if I can get up to here, but I highly doubt it. At least in the time span anyways. Might actually have to pay for to get these, get more event Rift tokens, but it's 300 Helix Crystals for just 100, jeez. Alright, anyways, I'm gonna show you something different. Before it was all assassination and all just lovely dovey easy fights. Now it's gonna be hard quests because my characters are technically underleveled and they are not really fit for this kind of job. I personally have used them just to get event points. If I was having it to be optimized, I would take out Teresa and add in Beatrix from before for the AoE damage. But I can manage. We'll go with this. So this is a very vastly different because I'm gonna have to actually brute force my way through for the most part here. And for the first part here, I'm gonna have to use Teresa. Gonna just throw some smoke in his face or dust. Ha! And then use my hamstring. Reduce his attack speed while slash for some little bit of AoE damage. And then stab and kill. Oh, lucky crit. Lucky critical. Holy shit. Double lucky crit. Triple combo. Holy shit. That was amazing. That was extremely lucky. And then you die. See how good Aguilar is? That's only because I've actually got him leveled and awakened, I guess. Promoted, actually. They call it promotion. If it wasn't, he'd probably not be doing as well as he is showing right now. But it's fabulous. Alright. Time for you to face the hammer. Hyah! Die! And then we get a Gagular again because he's just so useful. Ha! Throwing knife. You know, I wish I could see it here because when you throw a throwing knife, right, it actually gets stuck on their body. Let me see if I can just slow this down so you can see. See, there's a throwing knife on his neck! Dude, I think you're supposed to die from that, dude. So if I throw a throwing knife from behind their backs, right, it'll be a lot easier to see because the throwing knife will actually be lodged onto their backs. Should I risk taking extra damage to show you? Eh, fine, whatever. See, look at the knife. It's on his back. It literally stuck on his back. Oh my god. God damn it. You don't see it easily here now, but it's stuck on his back. So you can see it. Just like very telltale signs of it. Man, this guy's done a lot of damage. See, the knife is on his back. Jesus Christ, it's lodged in so deep. Anyways, this is supposed to be a game review. I've just been showcasing the game, I guess. Overall, I don't really know how to like quantify this game as a number, but if I had to rate it, I had to rate this game, I'll give it an 8 out of 10. An 8 out of 10, maybe possibly even a it's not that. Okay, I might even give it a 9 out of 10, but 8 out of 10 is good enough. For what it is, a game, it has to offer. It's simple, fantastic. I don't know what further into game, but I expect nothing vastly different. It's going to be the same gameplay throughout the entire thing. You're just gonna be farming, grinding, collecting your characters, leveling them up, and just basically just doing the same exact thing over and over. And if you can deal with that kind of grind, that's fine with me. Right now, I'm just waiting. I'm really waiting for them to release characters from Black Flag, because I really love Assassin's Creed 4. It was my favorite. It's my favorite Assassin's Creed game, and I really want the characters from there, like Blackbeard. I love how they made Blackbeard think to be a retard or a gay. I forgot what it was. It's such a long time, but yeah, this is the game. And as you can see, I just gained 5,000 points. It's so. It's just so close. And if I want to fully recruit, Cassandra and Alexios, I need to do so much. Alexio, I'm only at 2 out of 25. Whereas Cassandra is a lot higher. And I don't know why, but I feel like Cassandra is a lot better than Alexios, because as a DPS, an enforced fighter, right? She actually has an assassination skill. That's ridiculous. And even if it doesn't assassinate them, right? It will still do 200% damage to them. That's insane. And her special skill is reveal the rooms containing the objectives. Which might be good if you at the beginning when you don't know where you should be going. But overall, it's whatever, right? And then Alexios, he's the tank, where his skills, Spartan Kick. Strike an enemy for 70% damage. If an enemy is behind a target, both of them are damaged. This is Sparta! Put that meme on. This is, and he's also very good too. He's more damage and tank. It's very impressive to get, but I've only gotten two shards, and if I go four here, about, and then if I go any further, it's like absolutely difficult. Really, look at this. I need to go all the way this high, and the intervals are getting really higher. For now, it's like 50,000 points, 50,000 points. It's about every 50,000 points you get one, so that's nice. And then it goes here, it skips up to like 100,000, another 50,000, I guess, but the time interval between the two same characters is 100,000, goes to 150. That's ridiculous. Like, I don't even know what's the point of giving us this goddamn sword. It's only a level one shit, and I don't even know how you upgrade this. I don't know if it's possible, because clearly it seems to be possible, considering how much they give you. Like, look at this. First place ranking, right? They give you 5 extras of these. Why? Can you fuse them together to upgrade them? Maybe you can. I have not seen that yet, but yeah. Anyways, this is supposed to be a 2-game review, but seeing as the recording is already over longer than I expected, I'm gonna end this video right here. Like if you like this, subscribe for more, and I'll see you all on the next video. This game, you can feel free to try it out. It's pretty good. Also, free to play friendly as well. Aguilar is already a very good assassin to begin with. They can't possibly give you anything better. So there's a lot of games where they give you free characters at the beginning and they just plain suck. Anyways, bye!